ওয়েটটা উন্নত। বুঝছেন না স্যার? Morning all. Okay, first of all, I thank all the parents who joined their students in Lakshya Educational Institutions, Lakshya Junior College. Okay, the 10th class students, okay, you are the first batch. Okay, without any exams, you have entered into the intermediate examinations. Okay, up to now, okay, you have been passing from first class to second class, second class to third class, up to 10th class. But here after 10th class, okay, there is a great responsibility on your shoulders, because okay, some of the students before opting a branch, whether they take MPC or MEC or CEC or BIPC, okay, you are in dilemma. Okay, at last your dilemma is completed. You have chosen BIPC. That means you opted, you decided to become doctors. Okay, I wish you all the best for your future. Okay, you are the would be doctors. Okay, to achieve that task, to become a doctor, okay, you have to work very hard. You have to work, you have to do smart work. Okay, right. Okay, we here, team of Lakshya are ready to help you, okay, in regarding to reaching your goal. Okay, we all know that, okay, in Puranas we study, Lord Shiva has brought Ganga River to the land. Okay, it is called Herculean task, very difficult task, he made it easy. Okay, like that, what you have to do is, okay, you have to achieve seat in doctor seat, MBBS seat in NEET exam. Okay, that is your task here. Okay, in order to do that, we must have a plan to achieve that. Okay, now we go to our intermediate first year, IP first year. Okay, I am dealing here zoology. Okay, my subject. Before I go to zoology, let us start biology. Okay, biology. Okay, what do you mean by biology? Okay, biology is a study of living organisms. Okay, biology is a part of science. Okay, biology is a part of science. Okay, as said your previous lectures, chemistry sir. Okay, there are many branches in science. One of the branches is biology. In science, there is a physics, physical science. There is a chemistry, chemical science. And there is a biology, biological science. Okay, you have already studied biology in 8th standard, 9th standard and 10th standard. You have biology as a part, as a subject. Okay, can you tell me what is biology? Who coined the term biology? The term biology was coined by Jean-Baptiste Lamarck. Who coined the term biology? Lamarck. Okay, Lamarck is a French biologist who coined the term biology. Okay, do you know who is the father of biology? You have completed biology. In 8th standard, you studied biology. In 9th standard, in 10th standard. Okay, do you know who is the father of biology? Okay, many of you may not. Okay, who is the father of biology? Can you respond? I am seeing here chat. Okay, can you tell me who is the father of biology? Okay, here I am looking at your live chat. Can you respond? Who is the father of biology? I want quick response. Rasul Sheikh is there. Okay, he is telling Lamarck. Okay, very good. Can you respond? The father of biology is Aristotle. Who is the father of biology? Aristotle. Okay, now this biology has many branches. Okay, biology has some branches. Okay, one of the branches, you know, botany. Okay, botany is one of the branch. The another branch of biology is microbiology. Microbiology. The another branch is what we are studying now, that is zoology. Okay, biology has botany, microbiology and zoology. Okay, in botany you study plants, you know, study of plants. Okay, in microbiology we study microorganisms. In zoology we study animals. Okay, now can you tell me who is the father of zoology? Many of you may not know. Okay, some of the students responded. Okay, the father of biology is, okay, Archita, very good. She said Aristotle, and Sesek Naik, Aristotle. Okay, very good. The father of biology is Aristotle, and who coined the term biology? Lamarck. The father of zoology also, the father of zoology, father of zoology is Aristotle. Okay, who is the father of zoology? Aristotle is the father of zoology. The father of biology, Aristotle. The father of zoology is also Aristotle. Okay, this zoology again has some sub-branches. Okay, it has taxonomy, anatomy, morphology, okay, cell biology, okay, genetics, evolution, paleontology. There are so many sub-branches in zoology. Like that, botany also has some branches. Okay, you will be learning those sub branches of botany in botany, and microbiology also has some other branches. Okay, here I am dealing zoology. Okay, again, science has many branches. Science has physical science, chemical science, biological science. Okay, biological science, okay, that means biology, study of living organism. Who coined the term biology? Okay, Jean-Baptiste Lamarck. He coined. Okay, the word biology is a Greek word which bios means life, logos means study. Okay, Lamarck is a person who coined. He's a French biologist. He's the French biologist who coined the term this one. And Aristotle is the father. He is the father of biology. Okay, the biological science or biology has three main branches: botany, microbiology, and zoology. Okay, here I am dealing zoology. Okay, also called as animal science. Zoology is also called animal science. And who is the father of zoology? Aristotle. The father of biology and father of zoology is also same. That is Aristotle. What is the word? What is meant by zoology? Study of animals. Okay, the word zoology is a Greek word. It has taken from two words. One is zoon. The word zoon means animal. Zoon means animal. Logos. Logos. Logos means study. Zoon means animal. Logos means study. That means zoology is the study of animals. Okay, zoology is the study of animals. Right. Okay, now today, in these animals, there are many, there are millions of animals. Okay, these all animals are, broadly classified into two types based on the number of cells. Do you know that? All the animals are broadly classified into two types based on the number of cells. One is unicellular animals if they have one cell, and the remaining animals are called multicellular animals. Okay, now let us take about the zoology. What are the different animals, unicellular animals and multicellular animals? What are the different types of multicellular animals? How are they classified? Okay, let us go. Okay, details about that. Let us take In zoology, we study both unicellular animals and multicellular animals. Okay, zoology is the study of animals. Here, some of the animals, zoology is the study of animals. Okay, zoology is the study of animals. And these animals, based on the number of cells in their body, they are classified into two types. What are they? Unicellular animals. And what is the other type? Multicellular animals. Okay, can you remember in which kingdom unicellular animals are placed? In 9th standard. Okay, one thing I would like to tell you here. Okay, you are studying zoology in intermediate first year and second year. Okay, the zoology that you study in intermediate first year is extension of 9th class biology. In 9th class, you have learned what are the different types of tissues you learned. Okay, you studied ecology, environment. Those all things you study in intermediate first year. And intermediate second year, that is the extension of the 10th class. In 10th class, you learned recently nutrition, first unit, second unit, breathing and exchange of gases, breathing, third lesson, circulatory system, fourth lesson, excretory system. After that, you learned reproductive system, nervous system, chemical coordination. These all topics you will be studying in intermediate second year. Okay, what you study in intermediate first year is the extension of the intermediate first in 9th standard. In 9th standard, you studied what is cell biology, what are the different types of tissues, what are the animal cell, structure of animal cell, plant structure of plant cell. You will be studying those all things in intermediate first year. Okay, animals are broadly classified into two types based on the number of cells. What are they? Unicellular animals and multicellular animals. Unicellular animals are placed in the kingdom. Can you tell me the kingdom? That is called protista. Protista. What is the kingdom? Protista. Multicellular animals are placed in the kingdom called. What is the kingdom? Animalia. Animalia kingdom. Kingdom Animalia. In 9th standard, you learned 5 kingdom classification proposed by Whittaker. Okay, Whittaker. Okay, he classified all the living organisms. He placed all the living organisms in 5 kingdom. The first kingdom is Monera. The first kingdom is Monera. Next one is Protista, Plantae, Fungi, Animalia. Here in zoology, we are studying Animalia. In botany, you study Plantae kingdom, fungi, bacteria, you study Monera, those all things in botany. Here, multicellular animals are included in the kingdom called Animalia, which is also called as Animalia is also called Metazoa. What is that? Metazoa. Okay, the animals which are present in the Animalia, which are multicellular animals, are placed in Animalia. Okay, these are in Animalia. The animals present in Animalia are classified into different phyla. They are classified into different phyla. You are familiar with these words. Can you tell me what are the different phyla in the Animalia kingdom or Metazoa kingdom? You know these all, you studied in 10th class in excretory system topic. Okay, can you tell me? I will tell you the first one. What is that? First one is Porifera. What is that? Porifera. Porifera is one of the phylum in Animalia kingdom. What is the next one? Can you tell me the next one? Porifera or Porifera? There is Coelenterata. Coelenterata. What is the next one? Tenophora. Tenophora. What is the next phylum? Platyhelminthes. What phylum comes next? Aschelminthes. Okay, which phylum comes after Aschelminthes? Okay, I am writing here. Okay, the next phylum is Annelida. What is that? Annelida. Okay, after Annelida, which phylum comes? Arthropoda. Arthropoda. The next phylum is Mollusca. Mollusca. What is the next one? Echinodermata. Echinodermata. The next phylum is Hemichordata. Hemichordata. And the last phylum is Chordata, to which we belong. Okay, these are the different phyla. Okay, these are the different phyla. Okay, in the kingdom Animalia. Animalia is also called as Metazoa. The animals belong to Metazoa. Animalia kingdom are classified into 10 phyla here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 phyla here. Okay, what is the first one? Porifera. Next one, Coelenterata, also called as Cnidaria. Next one, Tenophora. Platyhelminthes. Aschelminthes. It is also called Nematoda. Platyhelminthes. After Platyhelminthes, I think you can't see this one. I am writing that one here. Aschelminthes, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, Hemichordata and Chordata. Okay, now I am going to tell you examples belong to these 10 phyla, okay, 11 phyla, okay, and some of the examples. Okay, now I am starting with Porifera phylum. I go up to Hemichordata. Remaining examples will be dealt in the next class. Nematihelminthes. Some of the students, they are typing here Nematihelminthes. Nematihelminthes is also called Nematoda or Aschelminthes. Cnidaria. Hi, sir. Kabir Singh. Okay, hi. Good morning. And Rushi Vigneshwar Reddy. Mollusca. Yes, Mollusca also one of the Chordata. Chordata is also one of the phylum. Okay, let us start with porifera phylum. Examples: today our objective in this period is to learn some of the examples belong to this one. In the next class, okay, I will be starting. Okay, what are the basics for related to the animal kingdom, and what basis these animals are classified? What is meant by coelom? What is symmetry? What are the different levels of organization? What are diplobiastic animal, triploblastic animal? What is protostomia, deuterostomia? Okay, we will be learning those all things in the coming classes. Okay, today I will focus on examples related to different phylum. Okay, I am starting here with the phylum Porifera. Okay, by next class, okay, you should be ready with examples. Okay, what we have learned so far? Okay, the first today I began with science. Okay, there are many branches in the science: physical science, biological science, and chemical science. In biological science, again the branches botany, zoology, and microbiology. Okay, in zoology again there are sub branches are there. The animals belong to in the zoology we study animal. The animals are divided into two types based on the number of cells. Okay, some of the animals are called unicellular because they possess only one cell. Example, you know examples. In 10th class, in first lesson nutrition, you have learned amoeba. You have learned paramecium. Okay, those are unicellular animals. You have learned type of nutrition paramecium. Can you tell me what is the type of nutrition paramecium? Can you tell me what is the type of nutrition paramecium? I am seeing here live chat. Can you respond to that? What is the type of nutrition paramecium? What is the type of nutrition human beings? What is the type of nutrition in human beings? What is the type of nutrition paramecium? Okay, the type of nutrition is holozoic nutrition. Okay, unicellular animals are included in the phylum in the protozoa. Okay, now I am starting the phylum Porifera. Okay, students, okay, before zoology class, okay, you watched about chemistry class. Chemistry sir said that there are 118 elements are there. Okay, like that you have more than 100 animals examples are given here. Okay, like you, how you learn of those elements, you have to learn these examples also, very, very important. If you don't know these examples, you cannot answer the question. Okay, before I go to this Porifera, okay, let me briefly tell you, okay, chemistry sir said already that one, mathematics and also physics sir said that what is the model paper in intermediate. Okay, we have here IPE, intermediate public examination in intermediate. Okay, in IPE we have zoology paper 60 marks, zoology paper 60 marks. Okay, these 60 marks come from 8 units. We have 8 units here. Total 8 units are there. Okay, what are those units? I will tell you briefly. First one, diversity of living world. Diversity of living world. Diversity of living world. The second unit is structural organization in animals. Structural organization in animals. This is our second unit. Total we have 8 units here. The third unit is animal diversity 1. Animal diversity 1. The fourth unit is animal diversity 2. Animal diversity 2. The fifth one, locomotion and reproduction. Locomotion and reproduction. The sixth one is biology in human welfare. biology in human welfare. Okay, the seventh one is Periplaneta americana. Periplaneta americana. The eighth one is ecology and environment or environment. Okay, these are the 8 units that you are going to study in intermediate first year. 8 units we have. What is the weightage allotted to these 8 units? Total our IP exam paper is for 60 marks. Okay, from diversity and living world. Okay, from this lesson we get 1 2 mark and 1 4 marks question here. That means the weightage is 6 marks. Structural organization animals 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 4. That means we get 3 2 marks questions and 1 4 marks from this lesson. Next, animal diversity 1. Okay, 2 plus 4. And here also 2 plus 4. And here locomotion reproduction 2 plus 2 plus 4. Biology and human welfare 2 plus 4 plus 8. And Periplaneta americana 4 plus 8. And ecology and environment 2 plus 4 plus 8. This is the weightage. This is the weightage. Okay, now I will tell you, already your physics sir, okay, said how many very short answers. In zoology paper, okay, I will continue this one. In zoology paper, total very short answer questions, okay, 10 will be given, 10 2 marks, okay, 20 marks. Short answer questions, okay, 8 will be given, you have to answer 6 into 4, 24 marks. Next one, long answer questions. Okay, 2, 3 will be given, you have to answer 2 into 8 marks, that means 16 marks. Okay, total 60 marks. Okay, this is the pattern of examination here. Okay, IP 60 marks. Okay, 60 marks, you have very short answers, 10, 20 marks. Short answer questions, 8 will be given, you have to, that means there is a choice. Okay, you have to answer 6, 6 plus 24. And long answer questions 3 will be given, you have to answer 2. Okay, 2 8 16 mark, total 60 marks. Okay, God, what about NEET? In NEET we can expect from zoology 45 bits, 45 into 4, that means 180 marks from zoology. So, okay, that means in NEET paper they don't give botany, zoology, they give as biology. In biology, sometimes there will be 50 bits from botany, 40 bits from zoology. Sometimes there will be 50 from zoology, 40 from botany. Sometimes there will be 45. Like that, you have biology in NEET exam. Okay, you study as botany and zoology, that biology topic. Okay, now let us continue the examples of the phylum Porifera. Phylum Porifera, this is the first phylum in Animalia kingdom, also called as the kingdom Animalia, is also called as Metazoa. The animals belong to the Porifera are multicellular animals. The examples here, I am telling you one trick here, SSC. With this trick, you can remember all the three examples. Okay, what is the first one? One is called Cycorn. What is that? Cycorn. The common name is Skypa. Skypa. Okay, you can remember this animal with a Bollywood hero, Saif Ali Khan. Okay, here Saif Ali Khan, he is speaking over Skype. You know, WhatsApp, Skype call. Okay, sometimes we make Skype call. Okay, he is speaking over Skype. Okay, Cycorn, Skypa. Next one is another S, Spongilla. Okay, the common name of Spongilla is freshwater sponge. What is that? fresh water spawn. How you can remember this one? Okay, Jilla means, you know, Jilla, district. Every district people require water. Which type of water? Fresh water. Okay, our district people require fresh water to drink. Okay, spawn Jilla, fresh water spawn. The next one is Eusponsia. Eusponsia. What is that? Eusponsia. The common name of this one is bath sponge. Bath sponge. Okay, I repeat again. Okay, you have just now, okay, a few days back, you have completed SSC, Secondary School of Certificate, 10th class you completed. Secondary School Education, you can remember SSC. To remember these three examples, here the first S, this one, and this is the one S, and this is one E. Why I am telling these tricks? Okay, because you have to remember lot of information. Okay, these, okay, our brain can remember tricks very easily. Okay, I will give you one easy example. VIBGR. Okay, everyone knows a child from third class up to intermediate, whatever it may be. Okay, they know the full form of VIBGR. Okay, when you remember the word, when I say the word VIBGR, seven colors are coming into your mind. If that VIBGR code is not there, it is very difficult to remember those seven colors. With that VIBGR trick, you can remember seven colors. At the same time, you can remember the seven colors in order also. Okay, that means it is enhancing your memory. Tricks can enhance your memory. Okay, neat exam, out of 720 marks, 360 marks, half of the marks you get from biology. Biology plays crucial role here. Okay, you have to remember a lot of information in biology. In order to enhance your marks in biology, you have to remember some tricks. Therefore, you can remember a lot of information and you don't forget at all throughout your life also, up to your exam at least. Okay, that is the significance of these tricks. They can enhance your memory. Okay, especially NEET exam, you don't need to write anything. That is the objective exam. Just you have to identify that option. Okay, that's why, okay, when you have this trick, you can easily identify that. Okay, that's why I'm telling the tricks here. Okay, Porifera phylum. This is the first phylum in multicellular animal. Okay, the examples here, Cycon, Spongilla, Eusponsia. What are they? Okay, are you listening? Okay, what are the examples here? Cycon, Spongilla. What is that? Spongilla and Eusponsia. What is that? Eusponsia. Okay, Cycon, Skypha, Siphonicon, speaking over Skype. Next one is Spongilla. You know, Jilla means district. Your district people require, your district people want fresh water. It is a fresh water spawn. Eusponsia. Eusponsia. You are taking bath with sponge. You are taking bath with sponge. Okay, some of the sponges are used, okay, for bath purpose also. Okay, Eusponsia is a bath sponge. Okay, now we move on to the next phylum. Which phylum comes after Porifera? What is that? Coelenterata, also called as Cnidaria. Okay, this is one phylum. We completed one phylum. Okay, by next class, okay, you must learn these examples. Okay, you must learn these examples. Please try to learn. Don't postpone your work. Okay, if you procrastinate, it becomes as a habit. Okay, you do the same thing again and again. Tomorrow again, you will study. Okay, you go on doing like that. Okay, don't postpone your work because you have determined to become a doctor. In order to fulfill your dream, okay, your dream will become true. Your dreams come true. Okay, when you work hard. Okay, Abdul Kalam said to dream. He also said one more thing. To achieve those dreams, we have to work hard. But we do the first thing, we do not do the second thing. We dream, but we don't do anything to achieve those dreams. But we have to dream, and also same time to achieve those dreams, to fulfill our dream, we have to work hard. Okay, right. Come to the next phylum. What is that? Cnidaria, also called as Cnidaria phylum. Okay, in this phylum, there are 8 examples. Don't be scary. Okay, I will tell you a trick. Okay, with the trick, you can remember those all 8 examples. Okay, in a jiffy, in a short span of time. Okay, let's get started. Here the code is AP, 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 Arunachal Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh. Okay, HM, Home Ministers, released one government order. AP, 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 HMGO, Andhra Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh, Home Ministers, released one GO. This is the trick. Okay, now we based on this trick, I am going to tell examples here. The first one is what is here? A. That means that example is starting with A. Okay, that one, the first one is Aurelia. What is that? Aurelia. The common name of Aurelia is jellyfish. Jellyfish, also called as moon jelly. What is that? Aurelia, jellyfish or moon jelly. Come to the next one. What is that? The letter here, P. Penatula. Penatula. Okay, penatula, we all use pen. Okay, that here, penatula, the common name is C pen. What is that? C pen. Okay, AP completed, Andhra Pradesh, A. Okay, Aurelia, the common name. Okay, you might have heard this word, jellyfish, also called as moon jelly. The next one is penatula, penatula. Okay, the common name is C pen. You can remember here, pen, pen, penatula, C pen. Now come to the another AP. Okay, that again, Adamsia. What is that? Adamsia. Adamsia. What is the common name of Adamsia? Is sea anemone. Sea anemone. Okay, sea anemone, Adamsia. Okay, I will tell you a short story here. Okay, you know one Bible story is there. According to Bible, the first man who came onto this land is Adam. Adam. Okay, according to Bible, okay, the Adam one day he was in a garden. He was in a garden and he was asked, I think as far as my knowledge goes, I am telling here. Okay, one day he was in garden and he was asked not to eat any fruit. But by violating the word of the God, he has eaten one fruit. That fruit got stuck here. Okay, that's why all the males have one apple here. This is called Adam's apple. Adam's apple. You can also remember this one, Adam, Adamsia. Adamsia, the first man, Adam. Okay, he was born in a sea. You can remember easily here. Okay, Adamsia, sea animal. Okay, now come to the P. Okay, Pisalia. Pisalia. Pisalia, the common name is Portuguese man of war. Portuguese man of war. What is that? Portuguese man of war. Why the name Portuguese man of war is assigned to this animal? I will tell you in the next class. Okay, Pisalia, Portuguese man of war. Okay, this one. Next one, H. H. Hydra. When I say word Hydra, one example from botany comes to your mind, certainly. Okay, in 10th class biology, first lesson, you have learned that oxygen is evolved during photosynthesis. To prove that oxygen is evolved during photosynthesis, you have used one plant in that experiment. Okay, you keep that in a funnel. Can you name that plant? What is that? Hydrilla plant. Look here. this is not hydrilla plant, this is hydra, not hydrilla. Hydra is an animal. Okay, this hydra, it lives in fresh water. It is called freshwater polyp. What is this? Freshwater polyp. It lives in fresh water. It's completed. Next one, what is the M? Mean Rena. Okay, Mean Rena. Okay, here its common name is brain coral. Brain coral. Okay, you know, in statistics you have mean, mode. I think mean and mode are there. You learned in statistics. Here mean, you have it in the statistics. Okay, to solve the problems related to mean, what do you use? You apply your brain. Okay, mean rena, brain coral. Mean rena, brain coral. Now come to the next one. G, Gorgonia. Gorgonia. Gorgonia, its a common name is sea fan. Okay, right now you are sitting, okay, with your mobile or laptop or computer, something in that room. What is rotating there? Okay, some of you might have switched on your ACs. Okay, some of you might have switched on fan, sea fan. Okay, the sea fan here is the Gorgonia. Gorgonia is a fan, sea fan. Okay, next one is the O, Obelia. I am writing here, Obelia. Obelia. Okay, Obelia, C-fur. Okay, with this trick, we can remember these all 8 examples with ease, without any difficulty. Okay, what are those 8 examples? AP, HMGO, Andhra Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh, Home Ministers, Release, 1GO Government Order. Okay, AP, let us take first AP. Aurelia, what are they? Aurelia. Okay, next one, P, Penatula. Aurelia, commonly called jellyfish, also called as moon jelly. And next one, Penatula, its common name is sea pen. Okay, Adamsia, sea anemone. Adamsia, sea anemone. Pisalia, Portuguese man of war. Pisalia, Portuguese man of war. Aurelia, jellyfish or moon jelly. Okay, Penatula, sea pen. Adamsia, sea anemone. Pisalia, Portuguese man of war. We complete up to this one. H, hydra, you learnt hydrilla plant. Sesamoid. Okay, next one, hydra, freshwater polyp. And Pisalia, Portuguese man of war. Mean rena, brain coral. And Gorgonia, sea fan, and Obelia, sea fur. Okay, these are the Rasul. Hi, sir. Hi. Okay, next one, Gorgonia, Obelia, sea fur. Okay, these are the 8 examples from the phylum Cnidaria, also called as Cnidaria. Okay, now we move on to the next phylum. That phylum is Ctenophora. What is that? Ctenophora, Patan, hi. Written their examples. Okay, this is the third phylum. We have only 2 examples are here. Okay, here the trick is you can remember these 2 examples with a trick called PC. Okay, some of you might have got PCs, personal computers, PC. Okay, here P stands for pleurobranchia. Pleurobranchia. The other animal is C, Tenoplana. 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 Okay, pleurobranchia, Tenoplana are the two examples that belong to the, are the two animals that belong to the phylum Tenophora. Okay, what is the next phylum? Which phylum comes after Tenophora? Which phylum comes after Tenophora? Okay, can you respond? Which phylum comes after this one? Platyhelminthes. 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 Okay, students here, I am asking you one question from our 10th standard. Okay, try to respond. How many of you can quickly respond? I will see here. Okay, which is called second brain of our body? Which is called second brain of our body? Brood over that. Think over that. Which is called second brain of our body? Okay, respond. Quickly respond. I will see who, which student responds very fast, very quickly. Okay, Platyhelminthes. Platyhelminthes. That we have three examples here. You can remember teacher, pupil, federation. Pupil, teacher. I am teacher here. You are the pupil there. Pupil means not P-E-O-P-U. Pupil means Vidyardharu. Okay, there is a federation. Okay, in that federation, there are the two members are there. One is a teacher community, another one the pupil community, teacher, parent federation. Here the trick is to remember these three examples. Okay, very good. Shashank Naik, he responded ENS. Very good. Enteric nervous system is called second brain of our body. It is present in our gut. It is present in our gut. Gut means elementary canal, also called a digestive canal or gastrointestinal tract. Okay, very good. Okay, Platyhelminthes. Platyhelminthes, the trick here is TPF, teacher parent federation. What is that? Teacher parent federation. Here the T is a tinea. Tinea. Okay, the tinea common name is tapeworm. Tapeworm. Okay, I am asking one more question here. Can you mention what is the hunger hormone? What is the hunger hormone? Quickly respond to that. Planaria. Another example is planaria. You came across this word. You learned planaria in 10th class, which has high regeneration capacity. If you cut our hands, we cannot regenerate them. But planaria, if you cut it into 10 pieces, okay, if you cut into 10 pieces, okay, nothing happens to it, but okay, it becomes into 10 planaria. Okay, planaria to it, but okay, it becomes into 10 planaria. Okay, planaria. Fasciola. Fasciola hepatica. Fasciola hepatica is commonly called liver flu. Liver flu. Okay, hunger hormone. One student responded here. Patan, leptin, hunger hormone is ghrelin. Hunger hormone is ghrelin. Okay, very good. Okay, leptin is a hunger suppressing hormone. Okay, right, very good. You tried. Okay, next one. These are the three examples for Platyhelminthes. Tinea, planaria, fasciola. Tinea, planaria, fasciola. Okay, teacher, parent, or pupil federation. Okay, tinea, planaria. Let's move on to the next phylum. What is the next phylum? That is Ascalminthes. On to the next phylum. What is the next phylum? That is Ascalminthes. In 10th standard, you learned Nematyhelminthes or Nematoda. Okay, it is also called Ascalminthes. Okay, Ascalminthes. Here, examples here, we have four examples here. The trick here is whack. What is the trick here? Whack, whack. W-A-A-C. Fasciola, another name. Fasciola, another name. Okay, it is the liver flu. Fasciola, otherwise called liver flu. Okay, rotifer, yes. Okay, Ascomanthus in nematoda. Okay, there are rotifer also included. Rotifers also. Okay, can you respond to one more question I am going to put on here? That is, what is the powerhouse of the cell? Respond to that. What is the powerhouse of the cell? Okay, Ascomanthus, the examples here, whack. Okay, one is Wuchereria. Wuchereria. Wuchereria is called, commonly called as filarial worm. You might have seen, especially in West Godara district and East Godara districts, where paddy is cultivated extensively. In those areas, most of the people suffer from one disease. Okay, you might have seen their legs swollen. That is called as elephantiasis or filariasis. Mitochondria, very good. Okay, the powerhouse of the cell is called mitochondria. What is the energy currency of the cell? What is the energy currency of the cell? Shankar Naik, he responded, mitochondria is called powerhouse of the cell. Okay, very good. Okay, next one, Wuchereria. Wuchereria, common name, filarial worm. Filarial worm. Okay, Ascomanthus. In Ascomanthus, one of the examples is Wuchereria, which causes a disease called filariasis, which is spread by mosquito called Culex mosquito, and which is caused by Wuchereria Bancroft and Wuchereria Malayi are the nematode parasites. Okay, the Ascomanthus parasites which cause filariasis. This is commonly called filarial worm. And Ascaris. Ascaris. Round worm. Ascaris, its common name is roundworm. ATP, right. Patan, he gave the right answer. Energy currency of the cell, ATP, adenosine triphosphate. Okay, next one is another ankylostoma. Ankylostoma. Okay, ankylostoma, common name is hookworm. Hookworm. Okay, name the enzyme present in saliva. Okay, give quick response. Name the enzyme present in saliva. Okay, next one, C. Cynorhabditis. Cynorhabditis. Cynorhabditis is the animal which does not harm us. It is a free living. It is not a pathogenic. Okay, you will come across this in the, you will study Cynorhabditis in intermediate second year. Okay, these are the examples that belong to the phylum Ascomanthus. Okay, these are the Ascomins. Okay, I will see here the trick is whack, amylase. Okay, very good. It is called salivary amylase. Sasank, he responded. Amylase or salivary amylase is the enzyme present in our saliva, right? Okay, Ascomanthus, Wuchereria, examples. Wuchereria commonly called filarial worm. Ascaris, roundworm. Ankylostoma, hookworm. And Cynorhabditis elegans. Okay, which is used. Whose genome has been completely sequenced. You will be learning that about that one in intermediate second year. Okay, these are the examples belong to the phylum Ascomanthus. Here the trick is whack. Okay, now move on to the next phylum. What is that? Annelida. The next phylum is Annelida. Okay, here the trick is HB pens. HB pens. HB pencils we use. HB. Here this is the HB pens. H means hydrodinaria. You know, in Telugu we call Jalaga. Okay, which is an ectoparasite. Okay, which is ectoparasite, you learnt in a 10th class first year, you learnt parasitism, you learnt some of the parasite. Can you tell me what is the dodder plant? Dodder plant, what is the other name for dodder? What is the other name for dodder? Which is also a plant, which is a parasitic plant. Here I am talking about ectoparasite. You learnt this one also in intermediate first, in 10th class first lesson nutrition. KBL, that is in commonly we call in Telugu we call jalaga, which is ectoparasite which sucks blood from the vertebrates animals. Kaskuta is the daughter, other name Kaskuta, daughter is the other name for Kaskuta. Okay, morning glory, Erogaceae is also called morning glory, right? Okay, very good. Okay, Annelida, in Annelida the examples are HB pencils here, Hydrodinaria, Peritima and Neris. Hydrodinaria. Okay, Hydrodinaria, its common name is, you know this one. Okay, just now I have told you. Okay, what is this one? Leech. Hydrodinaria leech. Okay, Hydrodinaria, here I mentioned B. Hydrodinaria, blood sucking leech. Okay, what type of leech is this one? Blood sucking leech. Blood-sucking leech. Okay, HB completed. H stands for Hydrodinaria. B, blood-sucking leech. The first letter here, B, blood-sucking. Next one, P. Here, Peritima. Peritima. Peritima, its common name, you know, that is earthworm. Okay, what is the respiratory organ in Peritima? Can you respond very quickly? What is the respiratory organ in Peritima? You have it. In 10th standard, you have it. Okay, Peritima, its common name is earthworm. What is the respiratory organ in earthworm? Okay, the next one is, okay, Peritima, earthworm, okay, name, N, Neris. Neris, its common name is sandworm. Its common name is sandworm, ragworm, clamworm. Okay, these are the three examples. These are the three examples. Okay, Hydrodinaria, blood sucking leech, Peritima, earthworm, Neris, sandworm. Okay, I have asked you a question. Okay, that is, what is the respiratory organ? Yes, very good. Okay, Shankar responded and Patan responded. Okay, right answer, skin. Skin is the respiratory organ in earthworm. What do we call the respiration through skin? Cutaneous respiration. Okay, that's about the examples belong to the phylum Annelida. Okay, the three examples here, Hydrodinaria. What are those three? Hydrodinaria, Peritima, Neris. Hydrodinaria, Peritima, Neris. The common names are Hydrodinaria, blood sucking leech. Hydrodinaria, blood sucking leech. Peritima, earthworm. Neris, okay, sandworm. Here the trick is HB pens. HB pen. Okay, what we have learned so far in today's class? Okay, we have learned what is science. We began with science. Okay, science has branches. Chemical science. Okay, physical science, biological science. In biological science, mainly we have three branches: microbiology, botany, and zoology. In zoology, okay, we study about animals. The term zoology coined by the term father of zoology is Aristotle. Father of biology is also Aristotle. The term biology was coined by Jean Baptiste Lamarck, who is a French biologist. Then zoology, in zoology we study. Zoology is also called animal science. In animal science, we study two types of animals: unicellular animals as well as multicellular animals. Unicellular animals are included in the kingdom Protista. In 9th standard, I told you there are five kingdom classification proposed by Whittaker. The first kingdom is Monera, Protista, Fungi. Plant is Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, Animalia. Okay, those are the, okay, in the Plantae kingdom, unicellular animals were kept. Okay, here I am talking about multicellular animals which were placed in the kingdom called Animalia. Animalia kingdom is also called as Metazoa. What is that? Metazoa. The animals belong to the Animalia and Metazoa classified into 11 phyla. Okay, first phylum is Porifera. In Porifera, we learned three examples. Okay, I told you one trick here, that is SSCE. You have completed SSCE. This is SSCE. Okay, secondary school of education. Here the one is Scipa, Okay, I told you Bollywood heroes Sky Falcon, Saikon, Skyfall, Sky Falcon, and he's speaking over the Skype. Okay, Saikon, Skyfall. Next one, SpongeZilla. Okay, your Zilla people require water to drink, which fresh water sponge. And you are taking bath. You are taking bath with a sponge. You sponge here, bath sponge. That is the first phylum. The next phylum is Ctenophora. Cylindrid, also called as Cnidarium. In it, I told you one trick. That is AP, AP, HMGO, Andhra Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh, Home Minister's release one geo. Okay, Cnidarium, Picaria, Adamsia, Penaculum. Okay, HM, Hydrinaria, Hydra. Okay, M, Mainrina, G, Garbonia, O, Obelia. Okay, the third phylum we learned is the Ctenophora. Okay, the third phylum we learned is the Ctenophora. The trick here is a personal computer, PC. The examples are Pleurobrachia and Ctenoplana. Pleurobrachia and Ctenoplana. Okay, next one, Platyhelminthes. Platyhelminthes, the trick here is a TPF, T-ring, teacher and pupil federation. Okay, the examples here are Tinea, Planaria and Fasciola. Okay, Tinea, common name, Planaria, tapeworm, Fasciola, liver fluke. And Ascalminthes. Ascalminthes, the trick is, okay, Ascalminthes, the trick is, Ascalminthes, the trick is WAC. Okay, Vocaria. Okay, W stands for Vocaria, common name filarial worm, and Ascar is roundworm, Ankylostoma hookworm, Cnidarius elegans is its common name is not given. Next one, Annelida. Okay, here the trick is HB pens. HB pens. Okay, what does the C stands for in Ascar pens? Okay, what does the C stands for in Ascar? See here, C is Cnidarius. 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 Okay, this is the trick is WAC. Okay, here Cnidarius. This word is little bit difficult to pronounce. Okay, this is Cnidarius. Okay, Annelida. Okay, Hydrinaria, blood sucking leech, Peritima, earthworm, Arnelis, sandworm. Okay, these are the examples we have learnt so far in today's class. Okay, in the next class, I would be coming up with some more examples. We complete up to the Chordata phylum. Then we discuss basics of kingdom Animalia. What is meant by habitat? What is habit? What is level of your tissue level of organization, cellular level of organization, organ level of organization, organ system level of organization? What are the different levels of organization? After that, we go to symmetry. What is radial symmetry? What is bilateral symmetry? Okay, next, after that, what is asymmetry? Then we go to coelom. What is acoelom, pseudocoelom, cytocoelom, enterocoelom? What are protostomians? What are deuterostomians? Okay, you will be learning these all things in the coming lessons. I hope this lesson makes sense. Okay, if you like this lesson, okay, please keep the links in the coming lessons. I hope this lesson makes sense. Okay, if you like this lesson, okay, please hit the like button. Okay, I am ending this lesson here. Okay, I hope this is very useful to you.